Hey family, how's it going? This is your girl Marissa, and I am here with the final product of how I did my gumball machine, aka yarn, aka great conversation piece. I absolutely loved how it came out, and as you can see, I did the rose gold color. I did a knob on there that is gold. Let me bring it closer to you to show you what I did. Maybe that's too close. Maybe I should. Yeah, I think you can see it really good there. I'll just bring the tripod to you. How about that? And then let's zoom in a little. And then zoom back a little bit. And there we are. And I think you can see it that way. So I did this gumball machine, as you guys know, and I used a gardening pot for the bottom and the top. And then on the top, I used a doorknob, a gold doorknob that I put right there in the middle. I love the contrast between the rose gold and the regular gold. Then I took my glass container that I had got from Michael's. Okay, I think I need to zoom out or something, because this is looking too big on here, and I want you guys to get the effect. Okay, there we go. And then so I used my clear glass bowl that I got from Michael's, and I used glitter paint. I didn't use the regular gold. I used glitter glitter spray paint. And first what I did, and I also put some candy inside of it. You can also put you could put a candle in there instead of the candy. A candle that maybe close to the size of this would be really cute, and maybe a little taller. You can also put flowers. I thought of putting flowers in there and then spray painting the flowers rose gold and putting them on the edges of the container. It's so many different things that you can put in here. I decided to put these little kiss candies, and underneath it is these little peppermint candies. Okay. Let's talk about the everything about this. What should I call it though? Should I call it a yarn, you guys? Or should I call it, because that's what it kind of reminds me of, that. And then it just reminds me of a good conversation piece, because people will be wondering, what is it, or what was it supposed to be? I decided not to go and put any hardware or anything at the bottom of it to make it look like a gumball machine. I decided that, you know, for my age and for my style and the look that I'm going for, which is more the glamorous look, that might make it look a little too kiddie. Maybe later on I may decide to put something here to kind of show that it's supposed to be like a gumball machine. But for right now, I like this. This is a good conversation piece. I love how the color and everything came out. What I wanted to show you before was the bottom of it. First of all, let me show you the top. The inside of the top, as you can see, I didn't paint it at all. I just left it this color, and I love how the color contrast, because the color is so close to the rose spray paint. Plus, I figured, what's the point in coloring it? Nobody is really going to see it, and when they do, it's when they lift it up to get some candy. Okay, let me show you the bottom. Okay, so the bottom two is, here it is, it's the pot, the gardening pot, and I didn't color the bottom either. Again, what was the point in that? No point. I love how it came out. It didn't come out what I expected, but it came out unexpectedly really good. I'm glad that I used the glitter, and I'm glad I didn't go light on it. The more I sprayed it, the more I loved it. It gave the glass a really good texture. I'm going to move in so you guys could kind of see the glass and see the texture in the glass. And it gave it this really nice kind of grady effect, grady texture, and I really like it. Now that it's dried, you can't even tell that it had some little blemishes that really looked really nice. And I ended up really loving it because it gives it a really nice vintage look and vintage feeling, which I was going for. My family members saw it and they were saying how really pretty and unique and different it is. I'm really glad I went with the rose gold, and I'm really glad that I went and decided to tint it, because first I was going to keep the glass clear, you know, just like how they do the gumball so you could see the candy. But it was just like something in my spirit said, no, keep going, keep spraying. And the more I sprayed, the more I liked it. I love it. It has like a really nice, rich, vibrant color to it. I hope you guys like it. If you guys decide to do it, let me know, comment, rate, subscribe. Let me know what you think about it. Would this be something that you would like to see in your house or a gift to, you know, a family member or so? I don't know what else to say. I'm just really, really pleased with the outcome. Here I thought it was going to be one thing and it ended up being another thing. That's what happens when you do these DIYs. Sometimes, you know, your first thought of how you want to do things that don't always work out. You end up finding something so much better and so much more prettier and unique. Just, you know, letting your imagination go. So I hope you guys liked it. I love showing it to you. And I will see you in the next video. Please don't forget to rate, subscribe, and thumbs up and ring that bell. Thank you guys. Love you. And I'll see you in the next video.